being a smaller outfit and being able to oversee everything that's coming through.
Right.
It's very personal.
Right. And the our manufacturer is a family run manufacturer, and they're small, and it's and they pride in what they make, and so that's why I say we're not putting anything that's not safe out there. We stand behind it. They stand behind it. And
right.
You know what? That's just how it's going.
Right. So let me ask you one thing. And as far as you know, we've talked a lot about how you came up with the belts and how you're able to stay on top of any of the newer features that people might want to see on here. But you know, when we're talking about how much load they can handle, or the stress testing and things like that. Are there any industry standards or certifications or things of that nature that
And in the beginning, we were NFPA certified. We had it tested. It went through all the strength requirements, and we still meet and exceed NFPA requirements for strength. Now, to stay compliant, I can't say that we are, just for the simple reason of labeling, which they change constantly on and off. And the labeling, I could care less if there's a label on the thing or not. And I don't think, if you're bailing out somewhere, and you need something that's strength, it's going to hold you, and we're going to stand behind it.
Right.
And the other part is third-party testing.
Right.
We don't, like I say, we're a small company, and it gets expensive. And every time NFPA comes up with a change, then you got to change everything, or you got to make your, start testing everything again. So our manufacturer is an ANSI approved testing agency.
Right.
In the past, they have tested it in the very beginning to see that we can meet the requirements for the strength.
Right.
And that's what we stand behind. I would rather worry about the strength requirements than anything else.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think that's probably what anyone who straps one of these things on is really concerned about. Is this thing, can this thing hold me?
Oh, it'll hold.
Right?
It'll hold.
Right. And so that's where it counts.
Well, you say, look at this thing here for 20 years. You could still probably hang off that, and I don't see why it would come apart.
Yeah. Well, I think that's...
And it's been in a lot of fires, I know that, because I know the individual at war, so...
Yeah, that thing looks like it's been to hell and back, and it's... I mean, it looks pretty sound to me, so that's... I think that says a lot about
it. It holds up.
Yeah.
It holds up. I don't know how many rappels I had on my belt, and it was... Numerous times.
But no, we stand behind it. I mean, it's a sound piece of equipment. I mean, it's of course it's nylon, but it's like anything else. You inspect it and you keep an eye on it. And if you're in a fire where it's flame contact on it, of course, I mean, you're gonna have to take it out of service. But from what I've seen from over the years in heated situations and things like that. I mean, it holds up.
Yeah, I mean, those same standards would apply to any other safety belt, right? I mean,
right.
There's no silver bullet. As long if like you said, if it comes in contact with fire directly, you're going to have to put it out of commission.
The biggest thing is, though, I would think, as a user, you want something you feel good in, you feel comfortable in, but God knows you got to practice with it because you're not going to figure it out. Just because you have a belt on, you got to practice with them. And practice with ours, and practice with other ones, and practice with all of them. Till you find something that makes you comfortable, where you know you'll be safe if you got to get out. I don't care who you buy, but make sure you got something.
And I found out you're not going to please everybody.
Right.
And like you say, but it's unfortunate. I mean, somebody doesn't like it, that's their prerogative. I mean, it's like you say, everybody's got their own ideas and what they're looking for.
Right.
Some people, a lot of people like it. Like I said, we've sold all over the United States and in China and things like that. And
right.
It's just it's something that's been just kind of going along for the last 20 years. And
if someone were to come up to you and say, why would I use a PacMule belt? What if you had to tell them in 5 seconds or 10 seconds. Right? This is.
I can tell with two words.
Okay.
Try it. you're not dealing with a car or a TV. You're dealing with your own safety.
Right.
So try a bunch of different stuff and find out what you like.
Right. The whole the whole concept was to free up your hands on the fire seat.
Right.
You're notorious. If you see anything on TV and if anybody's walking around, they got something in their hand.
Right.
And the whole thing was try to free up your hands. So that's why we had the drop down rings. You put that axe in there, you put that Heligan in there. If you want, you can end up putting a couple carabiners in the back and strap more stuff on there.